Welcome to a video on first partial derivatives. Let's start with a quick review. The first derivative of a function of one variable tells us the slope of the tangent line at a given point. This is the rate of change of y with respect to x. The first partial derivative of a function of two variables tells us the slope of the tangent line at a given point in either the x direction or y direction. Therefore, the partial derivative measures the rate of change of z with respect to x, or the rate of change of z with respect to y. Here we see the limit definitions of the partial derivatives with respect to x here, and with respect to y here. But we're not going to determine partial derivatives in this video in this way. In this video, to determine the partial derivative of f with respect to x, as we see here, we'll consider y a constant and differentiate with respect to x. And to find the partial derivative of f with respect to y, we'll consider x a constant and differentiate with respect to y. Before we do that, let's go and take a look at some different notation for partial derivatives. All of these notations here represent partial derivatives of f with respect to x or with respect to y. And one that I left off here is the partial of f instead of the partial of z with respect to x, and the partial of f with respect to y. And if we want to evaluate these at a specific point, we can use the notation as we see here down below. Let's go ahead and take a look at some examples and then look at the results geometrically. Here we want to determine the partial derivative with respect to x and y at the point 1, 2. So to find the partial derivative of f with respect to x, we're going to differentiate with respect to x, treating y as a constant. So the derivative of x squared would be 2x. Derivative of y squared would be 0 because we're treating it as a constant. Derivative of 4 is 0. Now we'll go and evaluate this partial derivative at the point 1, 2. Well, this only requires the value of x, so we'll have 2 times 1. That'll give us a value of 2. At the point 1, 2, the slope of the tangent line in the x direction is equal to 2. Now the partial of f with respect to y. So now we'll differentiate with respect to y and treat x as a constant. So that derivative would be 0. This will be negative 2y, and this would be 0. So if we evaluate this at the point 1, 2, y is 2, this would be negative 4. The slope of the tangent line at this point in the y direction should be negative 4. Let's take a look at that graphically. What we're seeing here is the surface in blue and the tangent line in black, and the point of tangency in red. And if I angle this correctly, notice as we move out along the positive x-axis, the line is moving up, and that slope in the x direction would be positive 2. Now let's take a look at the slope of the tangent line in the y direction. Notice now as we move right along the positive y-axis, the line is moving downward, and the slope of that line in the y direction is negative 4. So this is a nice illustration of what we're determining when we find partial derivatives. Let's go and take a look at another example. Now notice in this function, the first thing we can do is simplify this and then apply a property of logarithms to help finding these partial derivatives a little bit easier. What I mean by that is this is the same as natural log of xy to the power of 1/2. And then what we can do is take advantage of the power property of logs and move this to the position of the coefficient. So we're going to use the function f of xy is equal to 1/2 natural log xy. One more thing we should remember, the derivative of natural log u is equal to 1 over u times u prime. Okay, let's go ahead and find the partial derivative with respect to x. So we're going to have 1/2 times 1 over u times u prime. So 1 over xy. Now u prime, we're finding the derivative with respect to x, treating y as a constant. The derivative of x is 1, so we'll have 1 times y, or just y. This y and this y simplify out. So the partial with respect to x is just 1 over 2x. So if we evaluate this at the point 2, 2, of course x is 2, so we'll have 1/4. Now let's determine the partial with respects to y. It's going to be a similar process. We'll have 1/2 times 1 over u, 1 over xy, times u prime. But now we're treating x as a constant and differentiating with respects to y. So we'll have x times 1, or just x. So now the x's simplify out, and we're left with 1 over 2y. So at the point 2, 2, we're going to have 1 over 2 times 2, or 1/4. So the slope in the x direction and the y direction are the same at the point 2, 2. Let's look at this one graphically as well. We said the slope in the x and y direction would be positive 1/4. If we look at this along the positive x-axis, you can see it's moving up from left to right gradually at that point. This models the partial derivative with respects to x. And here's the model of the partial derivative with respects to y. Here's the positive y-axis. If we angle this correctly, as you move along the positive y-axis, that tangent line is moving upward with a slope of 1/4. Let's go ahead and take a look at a couple more. Here we want to find the partial derivatives with respects to x and y, and then evaluate them at the point 2, negative 1. This is going to require the quotient rule. Let's start by determining the partial derivative with respects to x. So our denominator is going to be x plus y squared. And then we're going to have the denominator times the derivative of the numerator. So we'll have x plus y. Remember, we're treating y as a constant, so the derivative of xy would just be 1 times y, or y, minus the numerator times the derivative of the denominator with respects to x, treating y as a constant. So this would be 1, derivative of y would be 0. Let's go ahead and simplify this. If we distribute here, we're going to have xy plus y squared, and then minus xy. So the xy terms are opposites. We're going to have y squared all over x plus y to the second. Let's go ahead and evaluate this at the point 2, negative 1. So our numerator is going to be 1. The denominator will be x plus y. That's going to be 1 squared. That's 1. I didn't leave enough room, so I'll try to squeeze it in down here. The partial derivative with respects to y, it's going to be the derivative of this with respects to y, treating x as a constant. So we'll have x plus y squared, applying the quotient rule. Then we'll have x plus y times the derivative of xy, treating x as a constant. So it'll be x times derivative of y would be 1. So we'll have x minus xy, the numerator, times the derivative of the denominator, treating x as a constant. That'd be 0, and that would be 1. When we distribute here, we're going to have x squared plus xy minus xy. So those two terms are opposites. We're left with x squared over the quantity x plus y squared. And now we need to evaluate this at the point 2, negative 1. So our denominator is going to be x plus y squared. That's going to be 1 squared, or 1. Our numerator is going to be x squared. 2 squared is 4. So this tells us at the point 2, negative 1, the slope of the tangent line in the x direction should be positive 1, and the slope in the y direction should be positive 4. Let's try one more. Here we want the partial derivatives with respects to x and y. We have f of xy equals sine x squared plus y squared. So x squared plus y squared is u. So the partial derivative with respects to x, well, derivative of sine u is cosine u, so we'll have cosine of x squared plus y squared times u prime. So derivative of x squared would be 2x. Derivative of y squared would be 0 because we're treating it like a constant. So our partial derivative with respects to x is just 2x cosine x squared plus y squared. Now let's find the partial with respects to y. It's going to be cosine u times u prime again. But now u prime, derivative with respects to y, this would be 0, and this would be 2y. And that's all we have time for in this video. I hope you found these examples helpful.